We can define a pattern. Let's say pattern is a literal A. And now what is a pattern? Well, it's a function. It's no longer a tuple. And so we can apply that pattern to a string, and we get back the set of the remainders. So it says, yes, we were able to successfully parse off A off of a string, and the remainder is a string. We can define another pattern. Let's say pattern 2 equals plus of pattern. Pattern 2 is also a function, and we can call pattern 2 of, let's say, the string 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 A's followed by a B. And now we get back this set that says we can break off any number of A's because we were asking for A, and then the plus of that, the closure of A, and these are the possible remainders if we break off all of the A's or all but one or all but three and so on. So essentially we're doing the same computation that in the previous incarnation with an interpreter we would have done with matched set of pattern 2 and then the string. Now we don't have to do that. Now we're calling the pattern directly. And so we don't have match set, which has to look at the pattern and figure out, yes, the top level pattern is a plus and the embedded pattern is a lit. Instead, the pattern is now a composition of functions, and each function does directly what it wants to do. It doesn't have to look up what it should do. Now, in an interpreter, we have a way of writing patterns, and that describes the language that the patterns belong to. In a compiler, there's two sets of descriptions to deal with. There's a description for what the patterns look like, and then there's a description for what the compiled code looks like. Now, in our case, of the compiler we just built, the compiled code consists of Python functions. And they're good target representations because they're so flexible. You can combine them in lots of different ways. You can call each other and so on. So that's the best unit that we have in Python for building up compiled code. There are other possibilities. Compilers for languages like C generate code that's the actual machine instructions for the computer that you're running on, but that's a pretty complicated process to describe a compiler that can go all the way down to machine instructions. Much easier to target Python functions. Now there's an intermediate level where we target a virtual machine which has its own set of instructions which are portable across different computers. Java uses that, and in fact Python also uses the virtual machine approach, although it's a little bit more complicated to deal with. But it is a possibility, and we won't cover it in this class, but I want you to be aware of the possibility. So here's what the so-called bytecode from the Python virtual machine looks like. I've loaded the module dis for disassemble, and dis.dis takes a function as input and tells me what all the instructions are in that function. So here's a function that takes the square root of x squared plus y squared. This is how Python executes that. It loads the square root function. It does loads the x and the 2, and then does a binary power, loads the y and the 2, does a binary power, adds the first two things off of the top of the stack, and then calls the function, which is a square root function, with that value, and then returns it. So this is a possible target language, but much more complicated to deal with this type of code than to deal with composition of functions.